Hey guys, what's going on? So we are in from West Glacier, Glacier National, on going to the Sun Road. My plan was to ride from the loop up to Logan's Pass, which starts at around 4,400 feet and climbs about 2,700 feet in just under 8 miles. But we saw a couple riding pretty much when we turned on to going to the Sun Road. We asked them if they were heading to Logan Pass, and they said yes. So my plan is to drive to a turnoff point and then ride with them up, which will be actually further out than initial. So we'll just try to find out where we end up, and we'll go up there. I got the walkie-talkies to talk to the family. We're in the car. The trunk is open. Just got the bike set up ready. So we're going to try to catch up with them, pass them, and join them up to Logan's Pass. So saddle up. Let's ride.
Get to about 5,800 feet, I think, at the top at Logan, so
Yep. No, we flew. I always pack a bike. I got an Oru case, so you do have to take the fork off, but it's $35 to ship it. Can't rent a bike that cheap. Exactly. I always take a gravel bike because you just don't know what terrain you're going to be on. Winvu.
Winvu?
Winvu, like Winnie the Pooh.
Okay.
You guys?
Topher and Emily.
All right. Yeah, we stayed right outside Winter Park. I got a buddy that lives in Castle Rock.
Yep. What'd you say the total elevation was?
From the hairpin up here is 2,700.
Left.
Yeah, from there. Thank you. Hey guys. About 7.5 from here. Leipheimer owns the KOM. Morning. Just made the hairpin period. Yes, please. Can I take it for you guys? I'll get a few.
Sure? Okay,
yeah,
so
yeah.
Sorry,
it
sucks.
No, this is great. It's a half.
It's like crazy. Because on the way down, you're not stopping.
All right.
Thank you.
You got one for yourself?
Oh, I'm good. I'm good. Appreciate it.
On it.
Appreciate it.
There.
Yeah, that's like everything. I did a Georgia Grand Fondo and it was 9,000 feet. It's like pretty much like some of the six gap climbs if you've ever been to Georgia and Helen.
No.
And it was 42 degrees, wet, rainy.
Oh,
9,000 feet of climbing.
That's cold.
Half the field dropped.
Mm-hmm.
It was
that's what happened. I did the triple.
It was
tough. It rained the whole time.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was hard.
I think it was 2 years ago that was terrible or something like that. Somebody
did I do it 3 years?
Two or three years ago.
Yeah, I'm sure it was that one. It was bad.
Yeah, it was a pretty epic one that was terrible. So yeah, take your time. You know, like, this has been pretty steady, actually.
Yeah.
It's not, like, just unrelentless.
Yeah.
Or switchbacks.
The switchbacks, and then you get, like, an extra 5% grade. And
yeah.
Oh, yeah, these are pretty awesome. And now is the time of the day to do it too. Yeah. Think driving from Apgar, you're following pretty much that that river.
That's the cool thing about bikes, you can constantly see what you did.
Yeah. Well earned.
Oh, yeah.
Turkey. It looked like a turkey. I don't know if that's what it is though. Tiny. Although you guys did have a headwind down there.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was trying to photobomb you guys. Sweet. Misery loves company.
Joining the Peloton?
Yep, I'll hop on my wheel.
From Illinois. It's still a super hilly day.
Pace for a minute.
Sure. At the Grand Fondo, she got pulled over twice by the same cop trying to do this for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Dedicated.
Fortunately, no tickets.
Dedicated. That was written in your vows, right?
You know, for better or worse. You can see the road down there. Thank you. These guys drive up from Colorado?
Yeah.
About 10 hours? 16. Oh, man. Nice. And do a video like this. Oh, it's beautiful. Yep. I started going easy and I tried to wait, but then I'm about to make that sharp left turn for that last bit of climbing up to Logan Pass. You guys see the ram back there? Yeah.
Amazing. Yes, please.
So great ride heading up. It's actually pretty steady. It's got some higher pitch areas, but it's actually pretty steady. Beautiful. I did not make it all the way up to Logan's Pass, which is up there. There was no parking there. So Desiree told me, hey, we are at the first turnoff before Logan's Pass, which is where we are now. But it was a beautiful scenery, as you guys can see there in the background. I just kept it pretty steady. However, unfortunately, again, I've had this problem with Shimano cranks before. This pinch bolt got loose. I don't know if the pinch bolt actually got loose, but then this actually got loose here. So you can see the position of the cranks. But right after I made this turn, so I guess perfect timing, which was great. I got to actually do most of the climb, 11 miles there, 27 to maybe 3,000 feet of climbing. Met some great folks there. Saw a yak or a ram, mountain goat, I don't know. Same area as what we saw yesterday driving down. But you could, as you can see all my way up, I mean, the scenery is beautiful. Again, met some folks from Colorado, Tovar and Emily, husband and wife team there. They drove up from Colorado, 16 hours, he told me. They've got a camper. And we were riding pretty steady together. And then I just kind of got in my rhythm and just kept it at around 220 to 240 watts there. Just beautiful. Glad I got to do it. Bucket list, going to the Sun Road. Just beautiful. So another one to check off the list. Thanks, guys.
This is K Squared Cycling. Be Khoi, be Khang.